Hello, my loves. I am Mom Agape. Welcome back to my channel, and this is MIL series episode 5. For the episode 5 of my MIL series, we will be discussing about the legal, ethical, and societal issues in media and information. So without further ado, let's get started. Do you have around 3,000 to 5,000 Facebook friends? Does having more Facebook friends make you feel good? How would you know if someone in your friends list is an online predator? How would you protect yourself? These are some of the questions that you need to ponder as you expose yourself on the internet. Not all of your online friends are real. Some disguise themselves as pleasing, presentable people, but actually they are just preying on you, or they have their hidden agenda. Therefore, it is important to know the legal, ethical, and societal issues in media and information. When we say legal, it's all about the law. When we say ethical, it's all about the right things, the proper ways in doing something. And societal, it's all about, of course, the social issues that we're facing now. So what are the legal, ethical, and societal issues in media and information? This lesson is very important for those who are unintentionally violating rules and regulations in the cyberspace, especially yung mga share lang ng share ng memes and yung mga posts on Facebook without even knowing if they are actually violating something or harming other people with all their posts. With the presence of internet, it is very easy to us to access things, and especially if you are very literate in technology, it is easy for some to access information, to hack information, to crack or to download things online. But we always need to take care or to be careful in all our actions on the internet. So we have intellectual property. Intellectual property pertains to the output of a person's intellectual pursuit, such as literary and artistic works, inventions, logos, symbols, and signs, as well as names and images used for commercial purpose of advertisements. So intellectual property dito mafufall yung copyright, patent, and that trademark. So if you are creating artworks or yung mga songs, symbols, and such, you need to apply for intellectual property para masabi natin that you have the right to that certain output. Now we have the copyright. Copyright is a set of rights granted to the author, creator of a work, to restrict others' ability to copy, redistribute, and reshape the content. That is why every time you watch the end credits of a film, meron dyang symbol T with a circle. So yung tawag dyan is the copyright symbol. So yung copyright, binibigay siya sa author or the creator of a certain work para hindi siya ma-reproduce ng other people. So hindi pwedeng gamitin yung isang output without the permission of the creator itself. Only the author or the creator has the right to reproduce or redistribute the certain output. That is why there are times na pag napopost tayo sa Facebook or on YouTube nang we are using a certain song as a background music, minsan nagkakaroon siya ng violation in the community guidelines because you use a copyrighted material and that is not allowed. And if you violate a certain copyright, that is what we call copyright infringement. Copyright infringement is, of course, the violation of a copyright. Ito yung mga tao na basta lang nagda-download ng mga pictures. They are claiming the pictures as if those pictures are their own. And gusto nila magpadali lang ng buhay. So, nagda-download lang sila ng mga contents on the internet without even asking permission from the creator. Next is the patent. Now, patent is an exclusive right granted to an invention. So, if you invented something, you need to apply for patent as soon as possible. Kunwari, ikaw yung unang naka-invent ng isang technology, but you didn't apply for a certain patent on that invention. Tapos, merong ibang kumopya na unang nag-apply, sino na yung may right? Kasi sila yung may patent. Also, we have the trademark. A trademark is a specific sign associated with a particular brand of goods or services. These are the icons that we usually associate with certain brands. For example, we have Nike, diba? Merong tread. Yung check na yan, that is the trademark of Nike. Yung mansanas na may kagat, that is the trademark of the Apple. So we have the fair use. Fair use refers to the copying of a copyrighted material with the purpose of using it for a review, commentary, critique, or parody without the need to ask permission from the copyright owner. So fair use, when we say fair use, fair, patas na paggamit. Fair use is a doctrine wherein it allows people to use the copyrighted material even without the permission. For the purpose of review, commentary, parody, or yung mga educational purposes. An example of fair use is when you create or when you write a movie review. Of course, you don't need to ask permission from the director or the producer of the movie just to create a review on that certain film. Now, let us proceed in the most controversial part of this lesson. We have the plagiarism. Kaway-kaway sa mga nagka-copy-paste online. Akala nyo, hindi ko alam. Akala nyo lang. Anyway, plagiarism is a very rampant issue in the society today, especially in this time where online learning is pervasive. So people, especially students, tend to copy information from the internet and put it on their notes as if those are their answers. Plagiarism is the act of using the ideas or words of others without giving a credit to that person. So technically, plagiarism is like you own something that is not yours. Ito yung mga nangaangkin ng mga content ng iba na hindi naman sila yung gumawa, di ba? Kalagay, I think media and information literacy is all about tapos insert copy-pasted material. Ganun. Tapos hindi nyo man lang gosh. Hindi nyo man lang kinedit. Kaloka kayo. At least give credit to the owner, to the rightful owner of that certain content. Because plagiarism is a crime. Do not commit crime. That is why if you are going to research, as much as possible, cite your sources. Because if you don't, then you are liable for plagiarism. Plagiarizing something would make it easier for you, but that would also make you a criminal. So please, in all means, avoid plagiarism. Now, what is the difference between plagiarism and the copyright infringement? Plagiarism is using someone else's work without giving proper credit, a failure to cite adequately, while copyright infringement is using someone else's creative work, which can include song, video, movie clip, piece of visual art, photo, etc., without authorization or compensation if compensation is appropriate. Next is the netiquette. Netiquette means the use of good manners in online communication, such as email, forums, blogs, and social networking sites, to name a few. Dito na pumapasok yung tamang paggamit ng internet. So netiquette is a combination of two words. Network etiquette. When we say etiquette, these are the proper ways or the proper behavior. How do we behave properly online? First thing is you don't type in all caps. Huwag kang sumigaw. Another is to make sure that you are using the proper grammar and spelling. Hindi yung rant lang rant ka lang, di ba? Hindi yung pa-English-English ka pa, tapos hindi naman pala sakto yung grammar or hindi naman pala sakto yung spelling mo. Sino pahiya ngayon? Also is flaming. Flaming is like nakikipag-away ka. But in this case, nakikipag-away ka online. Paano nangyayari? Nag-brand yung isa, tapos nireplyan mo, tapos nag-away na kayo, di ba? That is flaming. How we should be polite in real life is also how we should be polite online as well. Moving on. Now, majority of today's generation is very exposed on the internet. And with the presence of new technologies, the availability of affordable smartphones, and the accessibility of the internet, we tend to expose ourselves in the online world more frequently. Thus, we are also more exposed and open to threats and risks. Now, one of these challenges is cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is bullying that takes place using electronic technology. Electronic technology includes devices and equipment such as cell phones, computers, and tablets, as well as communication tools including social media sites, text messages, chat, and websites. So cyberbullying is bullying, of course, that takes place online. We are not sensitive enough on how we act online. Sometimes, hindi na natin alam na may nasasaktan na pala dito sa mga pinapang-post natin. Once na-harass na siya, or once na-hurt na, na-offend na yung taong yan, that is already considered cyberbullying. So please, please, please be careful. Next is the cyber addiction, or digital addiction. Addiction is like you can't live without something, right? Digital addiction is a phrase sometimes used to refer to someone spending too much time using Facebook, Twitter, and other forms of technology. So much so that it interferes with other aspects of daily life. Hindi mo na nagagawa yung mga usual routine mo because of too much time you spend on your Facebook accounts or in mobile games, Twitter, or whatsoever. Third is the digital divide. Digital divide refers to the gap between demographics and regions that have access to modern information and communications technology and those that don't or have restricted access. This technology can include the telephone, television, personal computers, and the internet. Now, digital divide is literally the division between those who can access digital technologies and those who cannot or have no access in digital technologies. So, baka nagkakaroon tayo ng digital divide? Possibly because of poverty. Diba? The rich people, they can have smartphones or gadgets, while the poor ones, they don't have because they'd rather spend their money on their daily needs rather than buying these technologies or these smartphones. Another factor of digital divide is the age gap. Diba? Kasi nga, meron tayong yung mga millennials or the younger generation, they tend to be more exposed to new technologies. But the older ones, they are not really technology literate. Hindi sila ganun ka-techy. So yung nagkakaroon pa rin tayo ng digital divide kasi nga, the younger generation, mas alam nila kung paano gamitin yung technologies compared dito sa mga older generation wherein nangangapa pa sila kung paano gamitin yung mga technologies. So, merong division or meron pa rin gap. So, in the first part of this vlog, I ask you if you have around 3,000 to 5,000 Facebook friends or if you feel good having a lot of friends on your Facebook accounts. The reason about that is because sometimes we are unaware that we have been adding or we have been friends with other people who hindi naman talaga natin sila kilala in real life. And there is a possibility na yung people na yon are posters pala. Internet is a very open space and it has allowed so many people to have access on different contents or on different platforms. Now, it is very risky to expose yourself on this kind of platform if you are not aware of your rights as an individual. It is important to be aware of your rights and your limitations as a media user because sometimes hindi natin alam are already violating some rules and regulations, especially here in the Philippines where we have the Cyber Crime Prevention Act. So that's it, yo guys. I hope you have learned something from me today. Always remember, do not plagiarize, do not infringe copyright, do not claim something na hindi sayo. Always remember to think before you click, post responsibly, and rant responsibly. So shoutout pala sa aking Lesbian Electrates, Media Moguls, and the Milo Chanko, and of course to all my supportive friends. I hope that you have learned something from me today. Hanggang dito na lang muna tayo. I will see you next time.